All right, guys. So before I start, I will let you know that this is the worst shape matting wise dog I have ever done. Comments will be turned off because I know there will be lots of hate comments toward the owner, and that's not what I'm here for. That's not what this channel is for. I'm here to help the dogs and educate owners. This dog has severe matting, and I had to cancel my dog after this because I know it's going to take me a while. I rescheduled them for tomorrow. So here's what the dog looks like. Okay, I'm wearing gloves because this dog is in rough shape. The dog smells bad for obvious reasons. I have a mask on because I really, you know, you really don't want to be breathing this stuff in, but you can see all of this is severely, severely, I mean, there's poop on the dog's butt, because they can't poop right. So, you know, the front legs and paws are completely matted. Okay, the ears are completely matted. The poor thing can't see. And, you know, the belly's matted. So, I'm gonna do what I can do. If it gets to the point where I can't, you know, I don't have the right equipment and they need to go to a vet, then I'll send them to a vet and they'll have to pay full price. They sign my client agreement. My client agreement states that if your dog is in such bad shape, coat-wise or aggression-wise, and I cannot finish the groom, you are still responsible for the full price of the groom. That's how that works. So I'm not even gonna try with a 7, we're gonna do a 10 blade, and we're just gonna get started. This dog smells really bad. You know, things happen. I've said this, things happen. You cannot judge a person by, you know, how their dog looks. Now this, you know, this dog has taken, it's taken this dog at least 6 months to a year to become this bad. Okay, this wasn't just happened because of the virus. So, you know, it's easy to judge people, but guys, we really don't know what has been going on. You know, we don't even know if maybe they rescued the dog and the dog was like this. I doubt it, but you cannot judge people, and we're here to help the dog, and that's what we're doing. We're here to get the dog back to a healthy coat. My table and all the equipment I use will be, just a minute, Kelby, will be sanitized, disinfected when I am done. Baby, I can't do it right now. You're gonna have to wait. Well, you're gonna have to wait a minute. So we're just going to get everything we can off that we can. This dog is liking it. It's, you know, I mean, I can't imagine what it would feel like to get this off. I did take before pictures, and I told her, I said, hey, it's gonna be a lot more than I quoted over the phone, because she didn't tell me that the dog was matted. So, and she just agreed, and Let me do your face so you can see. Okay. I'll do your face so you can see. Come here. Easy. You're okay. You're okay. Come here. Easy. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. Switch blades because this blade is hot. This is a marble serving table, serving tray. I put my blades on there and it cools them off faster than if you were just to lay them on the table. Come here. You're okay. I have, you know, some comments that, oh, you do it for the money. Oh, you do. Guys, if this person came to me and said, I cannot afford this dog to be groomed, you know, can you please groom it for me? Of course. You know, I would never let a dog suffer because an owner cannot pay for grooming. That is just, that's not right. Like, my job is not about money. It's about educating clients and helping the dogs. I'm just glad this dog is not aggressive. As far as I can tell, is not aggressive. You know, is laying on the tables, very chill. You're okay. You're okay. Good boy. When you're doing a dog like this, that where you're having to work, you know, in one spot with a blade for a while, you need to make sure to change your blades very frequently. They get hot and they can burn the skin. Just taking this slow. It's pretty matted in here. Okay, you can see all that's matted. Just gonna turn his head. Smell's making me want to throw up. I'm glad I didn't eat lunch yet. Change blades. You have to be really careful with the ears, because if you hit that, the ear leather, like on the edge right here, you will have profuse bleeding that it's really difficult to stop. I've never done it, but I've seen it, and it's not a pretty sight. I may have to go down to a 15. I don't want to, but I know it's driving you nuts, huh? I'm trying to get it off, boy. There's the edge of the ear. So we've almost got it off. There we go. There's the ear. Hang on. I know y'all are like, why are you saving that? So I can take a picture of it. You poor thing. You poor, poor thing. I am really glad that this dog is so chill. If this was an aggressive or hyper dog, it would take me twice as long. My dad came by to get my trash. We don't have a dumpster up here, so he came by to get my trash. Okay, so to be able to get down to this leg and fully do this leg right here, I'm gonna have to cut. I'm not gonna use my regular scissors because it'll ruin them. So these are my straight scissors. I don't use them. So all I'm gonna do, make sure I know where the leg is. And basically, it's like cutting off a cast. It's just going to cut this. Look how thick that is, guys. Look at all those layers. All right. While he was here, he got my daughter her lunch, and that helps me a lot. So. We're gonna cut this tail free of these mats so I can do it. Gently want to try to pull it back so you can keep going down, because I can't even feel. Oh, that's the end of the tail. Oh, that's great. Look at that, guys. That's insane. That is insane. This. I'm gonna try to clean some of this up in here. It's like that. Okay, just going to. Just too thick to. I know, I'm sorry. I'm trying to just. Okay, I'm sorry. You're okay. Yeah, okay. I may have to muzzle for some of this, guys, just because it is painful. Can you imagine your hair being so this matted and someone having to cut it off? Like, it's painful. You're okay. Switch blades. You're okay. I'll turn and do some of the other side. I'm getting there. I may have to take a break on this dog, give the dog a break, and go finish another dog that just got done in the cage dryer. Again, guys, all of my stuff will be disinfected after this, okay? Don't worry. You're okay, buddy. I am 100% taking a shower as soon as I get home. I know that. The smell just makes me want to puke. You're okay. Gonna cut this stuff off. know y'all are like, why am I keeping that? It's to... Hey, this is what came off your dog. You need to bring them in more often. You hear her back there. You hear her? That is ridiculously thick. You're okay, buddy. You're okay, buddy. I just don't know how I'm gonna get this off. Keep cutting it. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. All right, guys, I'm gonna have to take a break, just mentally, just because I'm it maddens me, like, and it's just I'm gonna go do this other dog and then come back so that dog can go home. I'm gonna put this dog in the cage and just take a breather. Give this dog a break too. Cause it's painful, guys, to have this stuff on ya. You're okay. Alright, guys, we're back with this dog. I finished eating lunch. Just don't know exactly how. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. I'm gonna have to go down another blade, down to a 15. And just get over this hawk. And for those of you that are saying, well, why don't you go report this person? Guys, I've done that. It doesn't do anything. They see this as the owners trying to better the dog's life by bringing them in for grooming. So it doesn't do anything. Sorry, buddy. I know. But I've got to pull that down so I can get to. You're okay, buddy. You're okay. Me too. Yeah, this dog is. Okay, just a minute. Finally starting to get this off. You're okay. No. No. You're okay. You're okay. This is a 30 blade. I will not go any shorter than this on any dog ever. But we're almost there, and I just want to get this off. And it's working. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. After I get this foot done, I have a dog that I need to get done. And I'll come back to this dog. You're okay. You're okay. A solid mat. Solid. I will put a reminder on my desk to message them in 8 weeks to let them know, hey, it's time to bring your dog in again. Gotta get these mats out. You're okay. Okay, so I gotta take a break from this dog. I gotta go get this other dog done and then we'll continue. Cause this dog's gonna take me a long time. Come here. You're okay. Come here. You're okay. No. You're okay. Come here. All right. Got to go down to a 15 or a 30. This is a 15. Thank you. I'd be hungry too if I was playing with my lunch and I didn't eat it. You're okay. You need to get down. I'd be hungry too if I didn't eat my lunch.
Can we go home
now? Nope, I gotta finish this poor dog.
Okay.
Get down, please. Well, we can go home as soon as I finish this dog. Name this dog Murphy?
Yeah.
I like it. Okay.
Because I know what is his name. What is his name?
I'm not sure.
I don't know. I
his mommy hasn't taken him enough, and so it's taken me a long time, and it hurts him a little bit.
Yeah.
because it's so tight, and so that's why he's whining. Yeah, I've asked you twice now to not do that. Easy. Okay. You're okay. tip. You're okay, come Hey, you're okay. You're okay. I know, you know I'm helping you, don't you? Try and give me kisses. But I don't want kisses. Easy. No. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. You're okay. You wanna sit? Come here. You gotta come here, buddy. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. Hey, easy. Good boy. Good boy. Yes. We're getting there, guys. 30 blade. I gotta check my phone real quick. Easy. Hey, you're okay. This hurts. I'm gonna get a muzzle. It is painful, guys. It's very painful. But I have to get them off, and I don't want to get bit.
Thank you.
Hey. You're okay. Very sore back there. Hang on. Hey. You're okay. I don't know why. I mean, I know it's because of the mat, but hey. Shh. You're okay. It's okay. We'll do this leg a little bit then. Hey, no. I know, buddy. Hey. You're okay. You're okay. Okay, I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna give him a break. I'm going to put him in the cage and give him a break for a little bit. 10-15 minutes, and then we'll continue. And if he keeps it up, then I'll just have to push through it and have to get it done. I know, I bet you're super itchy, huh? A 30 blade on here. I went ahead off camera. I just went around and trimmed that stuff. This sucks. trying to tell if there's a dew claw. No, 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 no. Hey. Hey, 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 you're okay. Hey, 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 you're okay. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. Hey. Quit. I'm okay. Hey. Shh. Sit. You're okay. It's okay. You're okay. I'm gonna have to go down to a 40. I never use a 40, but this is the time to use it. This is the shortest blade I have. Easy. Easy, easy, easy. Hey, 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 hey. Easy, stop, 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 stop. It's almost off. I know, I know. I know, I know. Hey, 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 hey. Shh, 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 shh. You're okay. It's okay. Oh. Hey. Buddy, buddy, I just gotta get it off. I know, I know, I know. Hey, 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 hey. Hey, it's okay. Come here. Come here. You're okay. I just need to look at it, buddy, buddy. Come on, buddy, we're almost there. You're okay. Hey, easy, 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 easy. Hey, you're okay. You're okay. Oh, that stinks so bad. Just gonna cut that nail. Look at how far in. Thank you. First thing we need to do is cut these nails. Easy. Hey, you okay? Easy. Hey, you're okay. I'll be so happy when I get this last one off. I am worn out. No. You're okay. I thought I was recording and it wasn't. But I'm just slowly going back. Thank you. Okay. I'll turn the TV on in just a minute, okay? So this nail is stuck in here again, just like on the other one. So I'm just gonna get what I can. You're okay. Finally got this dog shaved.
Now we can go.
I gotta give it a bath and then finish it and then we'll go, okay? That is crazy, guys. Just crazy. So, all right. Take this muzzle off. Go get him in the bath and then get him in the dryer and get him home so I can go home. He's been here since 10 o'clock. He's been here 4 hours. It's taken me 4 hours to shave, get all that off. So, it's been a while. And when a dog walks on, you know, that big of mats, it messes up the way they walk. I mean, you can see that both nails on the inside grew straight out instead of curved. There, you feel so much better, don't you? And guys, these little nicks and cuts, they're part of the job. When you're working with 40 and 30 blades trying to get mats off, it's bound to happen. That's why I make all my clients sign a client agreement before I start anything. You just wash everything really good and it'll heal. Really want to scrub them down. You know, there's going to be some spots where I'm going to have to put some antibiotic ointment. But that's fine. I'd rather them have a couple cuts from getting all those mats off than for them to, you know, where they can't even move around, be in pain. Yeah. just as suspected, the anal glands are pretty bad. Pretty bad. Look at that. That's not, ooh, that stinks. Not even done with them yet. Super, super nasty, thick, thick and full. I'll let that water drain down a little bit for a minute. Rinse the dog, put them in the dryer. Take maybe 10 minutes, if that, to dry since we're so short. And then we'll do the finished groom. Forgot to grab a towel for this dog. So, going to use this one. It makes me kind of suspicious when people bring in such severe dogs that are in such severe shape. It just makes me wonder if they're actually going to come back to get the dog, if they gave me the correct number. If they gave me their correct name even, it makes me wonder, and I really hope, for the sake of the dog, that they come back. But, you know, it's always a possibility with any dog, even if they're not in bad shape. I've never had it happen, but I've heard stories of it happening. While the dog is drying, I'm going to take this spray disinfectant and disinfect all of my tools that have been used before the bath, because now that he has been washed, there's no poop or urine or anything, but I don't need all these out. Here's what I do. Just lay him out. Spray him. Flip him. Spray him again. And then put everything up that I don't need right now. Let's try to organize as I go. I just give these a minute to dry. They're not 100% dry. You can see the film on it, but I put everything where it goes. I've had a lot of concern about, you don't clean your blades and you don't do this and that. Yes, I do, guys. I just don't do everything on camera. If I did everything on camera that I do from start to finish every day, my videos would be so long, no one would watch them. But I mean, even, you know, just going like this, it's disinfecting everything. It's because it falls down on everything. So I do disinfect everything. And this stuff is specifically made for grooming tools and equipment. So I just try to clean up because as soon as he's done, we get to go home, my daughter and I. And then for this hair, I will take a glove and put it on. And just pick it up, put it in the trash. All right. Get the tin blade. And the nail clippers. And I know there's going to be some people ask that, you know, doesn't it madden you to give the dog back? Well, of course. If you're, you know, a normal human being, of course it's going to bother you to, you know, give a severely neglected dog back to the owner. But it is what it is. And like I said, with animal control, you can call and report. They're not going to do anything because they see you, that they see the owner taking the dog to the groomer, so they're trying to better the situation, so they can't do anything about it. One of my groomer friends online said that she had seen a dog come in with maggots and was just in really bad shape, and they called animal control, and animal control said, oh, we can't do anything about it. They're bettering the situation. So, what the heck is animal control for? Beats me. I text the owner and I just let them know, hey, they'll be ready in 20 minutes. I sent the invoice to so-and-so. So I know when I get done with this dog, whether they're actually gonna pick the dog up or not. No, you gotta come over here, buddy. Easy. It's not gonna look 100% because it's so short, but it's 100 times better than what he was. No, Kobe. What? Baby, I can't hear you. You're gonna have to wait till I'm done, okay? I'm gonna muzzle him just to make sure he doesn't bite me when I do these nails. Also considering doing the Dremel just to shorten these nails as much as possible to help this dog. Quit. Hey.
What, mommy?
Just talking to the dog. Hey. I didn't even hit the quick. I'm going to attempt to do the nails with this. I'm not going to force this dog because he's been through a lot today. Thank you. Guys, when I spray, it's not just going to this side, it's going all over the dog. Oh, I forgot to get an after picture. All right, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.